Right, this week I want to talk to you obviously very quickly. I'll try and go through it. I won't get through everything, but that's okay. But I just want to run through something that you must know as a Christian. You must know how to apply this truth in your life if you want to walk in victory and you want a successful life for God. And it's in Matthew 11, verse 28. We looked at this at the prayer meeting for a few minutes, this verse. And Jesus said, "Come to me, all," does all mean all?
Oh, yes.
"All you who are weary and burdened, and I will give you." He didn't say, "Come to me, all ye weary and burdened, and I'll give you some stress." Did he? He said, "Same rest." Okay? There's a lot of Christians, and I've been in church not that long, but long enough to see Christians, and they walk like this, right? And they're walking like this, and they've got a big bag of weight on their shoulder, anxiety, worry, stress, you know, low self-esteem, no confidence. You know, the enemy's just pressing me down. I feel so weak. I can't walk. And they're like this coming into church. Have you ever seen them? Yeah? Turn to your neighbor and say, "I hope this isn't you he's talking about." Yeah? So they're walking in church like this. There's no joy. You talk to them. It's all about burdens and woe is me. And, you know, I don't know how I'm going to get through this week. And it really surprises me that there's Christians like this, because they're not meant to be like this. You see, after the cross of Christ, what gets us in, the free gift of salvation, and the cross of Christ, yeah, there comes another event called Pentecost. And at Pentecost, the Holy Spirit was poured out in power. Yeah, and Jesus will say, "Come unto me, all you who are burdened with all that sin, and all that bad stuff that you've done in your past, all those things that weigh you down, and what other people have put in that big sack that you're carrying on your back. And there come a day when you can come to me, and I'll carry it for you." How would you like somebody to come along if you've got a heavy load on your back, for somebody to literally, physically, to come along and say, "Hey, give me that sack off your back, I'll carry that for you." Yeah? Wouldn't that be good? And I've got good news for you. Jesus carries our sack, our load, and all our burdens. He carries it and he takes it from us. Now, some of you might say, "Well, you know, how does he do this?" Yeah? How does he do that? Because if it was easy, then why would people walk around like this, all burdened, sad, and depressed, and dying when they don't really need to be? Obviously, there are seasons when we are down and depressed and grieving, like Phil here, so I'm not, you're allowed to do that, that's fine. Yeah, but there's times when everything's fine, but there's some Christians still walking about with this heavy load on their back. Yeah, well, here's the deal, and here's how you get rid of it as Christians, right? If you're a Christian, say to Jesus, all you've got to say to Jesus is, "I can't carry this, it's too heavy. I can't carry it, so here's the deal, Jesus. You say that if I come to you and I'm weary, I'm burdened, you'll give me rest. Here's the deal, Lord Jesus." And all you do is you pray it over and you ask the Lord to take it from you. Okay? And then every time it comes into your mind and into your heart, you say, "Lord, I'm really sure glad that you're carrying that burden. That would really weary me and get me down and get me depressed. I can't function when I'm thinking about the children, when I'm thinking about the job, when I'm thinking about the finance, when I'm thinking about church growth, when I'm thinking about how to speak to people in a shop." Yeah, and you know, if I worried about what they said and their comments, that would be, I'd be putting things in the sack. And you know, Lord Jesus, I'm so glad that I don't need to worry, I don't need to stress, I don't need to have any anxiety, because you're carrying the load. But every time a Christian turns around and thinks about it and doesn't acknowledge that they can't carry it and Jesus is carrying it, then they are carrying it themselves. They're carrying it themselves. I could not be a pastor if I carried all the worries and all the stress that not you guys, but all the guys that aren't here, yeah, that they give me, yeah, and all the stress and problems of the church. If I carried that, I'd be off. Yeah, I would be like Bob. Yeah, I'd be gone. I couldn't do it. I can only do it because I don't carry it. It's God's church. Use your God's people. Yeah? Use the fool yourselves through the power of the Holy Spirit. But there's a lot of Christians who don't have the power of the Holy Spirit. The Holy Spirit comes into your life and gives you great power. Now, the power of the Holy Spirit is like an inner voice of God in your mind and in your heart. And that inner voice will say to you, don't fret, don't worry, I'm with you, I will never leave you nor forsake you. Greater is he that's in you than he that's in the world. Don't worry, stop fretting. I am me Jehovah, Eugene, me Jehovah, yeah? And that inner voice says this to you, and we're supposed to say, thank you, God. Can't do it in my own strength. When we do that, so every time this pressure comes into your life, whenever you say, thank you, Jesus, for dying on the cross, for taking it, for carrying all my burdens, all my worries, all my family life, all the situations, thank you, Lord. Do you know what? You don't need to think about it again. Some people get so stressed with their jobs. I was in the shop yesterday, right? And Tanya was with me, a new Christian, came in the church last week. Yeah? Tanya was in that shop. And I don't know if Tanya noticed an autistic child boy in the shop. I don't know if you noticed that child or not. But there was somebody with autism, I suppose it was autism, in the shop. And he came to me and he was talking to me, and what's your name? I said, I'm George. He says, what's your second name? I said, McMullan. He said, how do you spell it? I said, McMullan. He says, right. And his mum was there with a little dog, and was stroking a little dog and everything. I think it was his mother. And she says, he'll never forget your name. He'll never forget your name. All his life. He won't, my dad can't even remember his name. He told me. But I can't remember who he was called. And I says, really? She says, yeah. He says, what age are you? I says, I'm 51 coming up to 52. He says, when were you born? I said, well, and this, and people were listening, by the way. I said, the 16th of September, 1963. That's a Monday. That was a Monday. And I look at his mom, and I says, I don't know if it's a Monday. Does he know what day of the week I was born? She says, yeah, Monday. He's never wrong. But when I get out of that shop, if you know what Sarah is on your phone, Google, you can press the button, you can call your phone nowadays. So I pressed it, and I said, what day of the week is the 16th of September, 1963? And do you know what it said?
Monday.
I'd love to say Tuesday, but no. Yeah, he's quite deserved. But no, it was Monday. Monday. Now, do you know when I researched a little message for today about stress, the number one killer of people? Stress kills you. Do you know what it said? What day of the week do you think people get the most heart attacks on?
Monday.
You're dead. Yeah, so I know what day I'm going. What the? You're trusting. Yeah. So, yeah. Monday. Do you know why?
Because it's beginning of the week.
Thank you, Phil. You're brilliant. You just keep this up. I love interacting. I interact because I know you're not falling asleep then. I know you're interacting. Yeah, Monday. Because of work. The reason people get stressed for work is because they think the job is who they are. The job's not who you are. It's what you do. Not who you are. And because some people think the job is who they are, when they get to work, yeah, they don't like the job. They don't give it their best. They don't do it as unto the Lord. They don't do it with a song in their heart. They don't do it because it's a ministry. shopping, don't matter what you do, really. You meet people no matter where you are. Yeah? And if you even wash the dishes, and I find this, do you know one way you can get stressed away when you wash dishes? Just focus on getting them squeaky clean. Yeah? If you're focusing on getting all that dirt off, you don't have to do them twice. And men know what I'm on about. Yeah? I don't want to do them twice, so I get them squeaky clean for Claire. Yeah? She does make me do them twice, by the way. So I did have a dishwasher. I've got a dishwasher, but not a wicking fix in it. So when I get focused, do you know what? When your mind's on the work, the job, the task in hand, getting a really good job in these places, you don't remember your stress anymore. It's true, isn't it? If you get focused on something, you go to a theme park and you're all stressed, you get on one of those rides on a theme park and you let yourself go, you're not stressed, you're not thinking about your kids and your job when you're on that ride. You're thinking about, are you going to survive it? Are you going to fall out or crash? Which will not go there, but it can happen. Yeah, so you're not thinking. So it's all about perspective. Yeah, when your mind, do you know God says in Proverbs that He'll bless your days and He'll give you more days if you do it unto the Lord. Whatever you do unto the Lord and the Lord will bless you. He'll give you a great life. He'll come to give you a abundant life. Do not fall into the snare of the enemy where you've got to walk about with this big sack load of problems and worries. And you know, when you're free, other people will see it. They'll see the joy of the Lord in your heart. They'll see happiness. Everyone's looking for happiness. That's what everyone's looking for. But they're looking in all the wrong places for happiness. We've got it here. We've got genuine happiness that's better than a drug. And I've used some drugs. Yeah? And there's no high like the Most High. Yeah? When you become a Christian, you praise the Lord. You can do it day or night. Yeah, you can do it wherever you go. You can praise the Lord and you're on a high. Do you know I was 10 feet tall yesterday, as far as you speak? 10 feet tall. When I watched Phil, tattoos, dress, Dan, Edward, right? When I watched them handing out leaflets, the people, nobody in this church ever judges anybody, because we know we're going to get a lot of different types of people. They're not all going to be like us. And I felt 10 feet tall, and I really did spiritually, for God blessing us, and everyone behind the stall, and all the sacrifice, and everyone who got there and came back, and the way it all run, and the way they talked and communicated, because it wasn't easy. Somebody did say the F word to me, with off, on the behind it, and my first thought was, run off from there, and then I thought, and then the power of God, the Holy Spirit said to me, hey, forgive the guy, you were just like that, you were worse, I was worse than that, yeah, so the grace and the power of God is available every day, so I didn't go there, and I prayed for the guy. I know that guy and other people spoke to these guys similar yesterday. Some of them have told me this. Not one of them reacted. That can only be the power of God. In fact, some people didn't even want a leaflet. They couldn't get past Phil, or they couldn't get past Edward. I knew what was coming, you see. When I get a leaflet, it's not my gift, it's not my calling to give out leaflets. I find that out yesterday. They were taking them off me. They give out hundreds. Yeah, they weren't taking them off me. But try saying no to Dad. Or try saying no to Phil and Edward. Try saying no to Edward. Yeah, they couldn't. I knew what was coming. And one of them caught them. We were fishing yesterday. That's what we were doing. We were out there where Christians should be. We were fishing. We were back to the Bible. Yesterday, and a lot of them were caught. I don't understand why they're not here. Don't need to understand. God knows, and it's God's church. They will be in. And a lot of people were caught yesterday. Lunching club will grow, the church will grow, and the enemy isn't going to be able to stop us and the work that God's doing in our lives. Now, another thing that I think stresses people physically, I'm not talking about spiritually. that you know spiritually as a Christian, that the day of the rest with the Lord is every day. Spiritually, you're saved, you're in God's kingdom, you don't need to worry about it, you're sanctified, you're touched through the power of the Holy Spirit. You enter into God's rest now, here on earth. The work is finished spiritually. But physically, we're still here on earth. And God did something amazing in Exodus chapter 20. He said that human beings would do best if they had one day a week to rest. That's what he did. And so he gave us the Sabbath day, the Sabbath rest. Yeah? And what he said on that day was that if you go to church or synagogue or whatever, in Jesus' time, you come to church and you worship here for 1 hour, or an hour and a half in church, yeah, and you worship to God, you'll live longer, and this is a known fact. People who come to church and worship and give God that hour and a half or so in a worship service, they live longer and they are healthier people. Known fact. And because they analyze it with communist countries that don't believe in God and don't have a day of rest, and the health of those people, they die younger than usual, and they weren't as healthy as usual.